Hey guys, welcome back to another Who Owned That Era video. Since my last installment in this little series was Blackpink and it did so well, I decided to do another version with BTS. BTS was by far my most requested group, so here we are. Basically, if you don't already know how these kinds of videos work, I just go through each era of a specific K-pop group and choose who I think owned each era based on my personal preference. And what I mean by era is each album, so I'm excluding any Japanese installments to save time, but basically I look at who overall shined the most out of all the members, and I look at music videos, live stages, concept photos, stage presence, visual, overall vibe, etc. It's a lot harder than it looks, don't get me wrong, but let's not waste any more time and let's just get started with the video. What an iconic debut era for BTS. It's really a shame that a lot of new fans don't take the time to appreciate this delicious content. Okay, first of all, J-Hope owned this era without a doubt, mainly because forehead. Okay, J-Hope's forehead is a beautiful thing that I miss dearly. Big hit, I don't ask for a lot. J-Hope just owned every bit of these concepts to me. I loved his like bad boy vibes with like his little bandana thing. He could literally spit on me and I'd be like, thanks. I personally think Namjoon owned this era because of his raps. I loved his specific part in the title track the most. The lyrics spoke to me so much. I love this song, No, so much. Like, the message behind it is very meaningful. But yeah, RM owned it completely. I absolutely die every time I hear Taehyung's deep ass voice in Boy in Love. Like, it literally suffocates me. No, but I think he fits this bad boy emo rocker concept so well, and he looked so cute this era. We love stud earrings in this economy. One of the best times to be alive was Dark and Wild era. I initially thought Jungkook owned this because of his rapping. Honestly, I miss that shit. Like, why did it go away? But I ultimately had to go with Jimin because, well, this. In Danger, when he was like punching the punching bag and like flexing his biceps all over the place, and the high notes, shit. And in War of Hormone, that like tasseled hair with those motherfucking suspenders and red pants. Y'all, if Jimin doesn't shut up soon, I'm gonna have to go. But Dark and Wild era remains superior. I'm ready to fight anybody. Like, literally, they sung about how women are perfect in the front and in the back. We stand. What the fuck? This era was the era when I feel like BTS legit became men. Like, BTS was no longer a boy group, they became a whole ass man group. We were given two of the most iconic bops in this album, I Need You and Dope. Both very different, but both fucking legendary. Okay, first of all, this era was so hard to choose because, well, yeah. But I think Jungkook wholeheartedly took this era and snatched it and absorbed every last fucking bit of it. The whole cop uniform and the lip gloss and the emo dreamy boyfriend look in Dope. And he had like the fucking purple hair or whatever. Could he be any more flawless? No. And I love his vocals and I Need You. Like, that's my bias. That's my whole fucking bias. don't even question that. Breathe if you agree. Run. What a wholesome track. The looks this era were nothing shy of flawless, and Yoongi with that mint green hair, yes, please. It was between him and Namjoon because of Namjoon's fucking pink hair and the looks. Oh my god, this era is such gold, but Suga just fit this concept so well, and I think he really stood out on stage in the dance practice. Go off, honestly. So underrated, and it's so sad. But anyways, Alexa, play Run, please. Yeah, so Young Forever was such a pure and ethereal era for BTS. I miss that shit. But anyways, Jin shined so much this era. Firstly, in Fire, there's this one scene in Fire that made Jin my bias for like a hot minute there. He kept touching his lips and like looking dead straight into the camera lens. I'm like, sir, what the fuck? Like, is there something you need? And his platinum like Draco Malfoy looking hair and his dancing improved so much. He was the whole package in Fire. And then in Save Me, oh god, I don't even want to talk about his visual. Like, he had that damn like black baseball cap with like the all black outfit, the ripped jeans looking fine for no reason. God, I love Save Me so much. I actually might start crying if I talk about it for too long. It's so simple yet so perfect. Like, they didn't even have to do anything fancy. They literally just stood in a field dancing, breathing. Like, it's literal cinematic art. Give them Oscars, please. What the fuck? Listen, guys, I don't know a lot, okay? I really don't. But what I do know is that Jimin in Blood, Sweat, and Tears is one of the greatest things that has ever happened to humanity, and he remains unmatched. Find the lie, please. It's impossible because it's only fact. Like, Jimin could be off to one side in one shot of the music video, but you best believe that my eyes are glued to that man. No ifs, ands, or buts. Like, I personally want to give Wings era stylists my life savings, my virginity, my car, because they deserve that shit. His elegance, his grace, his fucking posture in that music video in this whole era is literal perfection. Like, the V-neck with the fucking choker thing, like, what the fuck? And when he, like, pushed the shirt and we saw his fucking shoulder, I've never in my life been so sexually attracted to a shoulder before. His power, honestly. Jimin put his literal blood, sweat, and tears into Wings era. Okay, next. Okay, so the actor in Jungkook jumped out in You Never Walk Alone era. Firstly, in Spring Day, his vocals, honestly, like, he sounded so angelic and like heavenly, and he looked absolutely beautiful in the music video. I felt the song went so well with his voice. And in Not Today, I thought he pulled off that concept so well. Like, he was fucking dancing, going in, doing his thing. I overall just think that Jungkook owned You Never Walk Alone era with his whole magne soul. Okay, what the fuck? This was without a doubt so unbelievably hard for me to choose because Love Yourself Her was that bitch and nobody can deny its iconicness. Is iconicness a word? Why is this always a problem for me? Anyways, Each member excelled in their own special ways, okay? Jimin owned that sequin jacket. I don't want to hear it. He owned that shit, okay? Serendipity, which still remains the bop of all bops. Anyways, J-Hope's part in Mic Drop rips me the fuck up. Like, he went in that opening verse. Whenever that shit comes on, I prepare myself for death. Like, Mic Drop goes hard, okay? But after observing Love Yourself, Her era, I decided that Taehyung gave us something this era that I would truly never forget. Okay, first of all, his visual in DNA is the reason I haven't died off yet. And then Mic Drop, sis, okay. Taehyung and Mic Drop, with that fucking bandana headband, whatever the fuck. Oh my god. Lord, please forgive me, for I have sinned and I'm probably going to hell, okay? And when he said hella thick, just the smoothness of it all. Like, he had me whipped. Everything about Taehyung this era was so correct. Although Yoongi was like 3 seconds away from taking it, I don't know, I guess just me and bandanas fuck with each other, but Taehyung still managed to snatch the mostest. 날 위해서 하면 날 슬퍼도 기쁜 척할 수가 있어서 우리만의 수 너는 없었어 내가 봐도 무 잊어버렸어 나도 내가 누구였는지도 잘 모르게 돼 an era full of literal bop after bop. Okay, this album remains tasteful as hell. It felt so short though, like this whole era felt so short. Anyways, first of all, we saw a side of J-Hope in this era that we have not seen in a hot ass minute. He was so sexy and mature this era. His facial expressions during the performances caught me off guard. Even though Jungkook's my bias, my eyes were on Hobie. Okay, you best believe. And not to mention his part in Fake Love is my favorite part of the entire song. He goes off. I know a lot of you guys probably thought I was gonna choose Jungkook because, well, this, okay? But J-Hope laying on a pile of Snickers was everything I could have asked for and more. Can't call me artist. Can't call me idol. Why do I feel like Idol came out like last week? Like, these months are flying by. Anyways, regarding Love Yourself Answer, Jimin visually grabbed this era by its neck and ripped that shit. But overall, I just love Namjoon during this era, like his flow, his parts, especially in I'm Fine. Namjoon killed this song. I loved him in Idol as well. He just looked very attractive and very confident. And sounded so smooth. Like, wow, what a man, honestly.